Apart from moving objects inside a drawing, it is highly possible that we will also need to rotate those items to fix their orientation. The tool for rotating the objects of a drawing is called Rotate. For this example, I have opened a drawing where a kitchen's floor plan has been created. However, I want to change the direction of the table along with the chairs in such a way that the back of the chairs will be facing the window. For this reason, I will activate the Rotate command. The Rotate command can be found in either the Modify menu or in the Home ribbon if we look at the panel Modify. As for me, I will click on the Rotate icon on the Home ribbon. Once the tool is active, a message prompts me to select the objects I wish to rotate. I will select the table and the chairs and I will press Enter. Just like the Move and Copy commands, I need to specify a base point. This time, the base point represents the center of rotation, namely the point around which the object will rotate. This point doesn't change direction, so another trick to choose the base point is to think which point you wish to remain in the same position. Since I wish the center of rotation to coincide with the center of the table, I will open the snaps list and make sure that only the midpoint snap is active. Then I will close the list and move my cursor on the middle of the table's upper side. Once the midpoint snap appears, I will wait a few seconds without moving the cursor and especially without clicking. Notice that as I move the cursor downwards, a reference line appears. Now, I will move the cursor to the point of the right side of the table, wait a few moments again without clicking, and then I will move the cursor to the left. Another reference line appears. The point which those two reference lines intersect is the center of the table, and this is where I will click to specify the base point. Next, I need to specify the rotation angle. Since I want to rotate the table set 90 degrees, I will type the number 90 and press Enter. Notice that the command deactivated automatically and the back of the chairs are now indeed facing the window. In the next example, I will show you how to rotate an object when you don't know the exact angle of rotation, but there is a reference line or object you can use for the rotation. As you can see, in this drawing there's a simple room's floor plan. In this room there is a bed. However, the room has been created at an angle, so when the bed was placed in it, the orientation wasn't the same. To fix that, I will activate the Rotate tool, select the bed, and press Enter. However, since I do not know the exact angle, I will use the wall as a reference. At this point, I will open the snaps list and activate the endpoint again. Then, I will set the base point to the upper left corner of the inner wall. In this way, the bed rotates around this corner, but this is not what I wanted. I want you to look at the command line. There, we can find the copy option and the reference option. With a copy option, we create a rotated copy of the object we have selected. With the reference option, I can rotate an object based on two reference points, which is what I want to do right now. So, after I click on it, I need to specify the reference angle by defining two points. I will click on the endpoint of the upper left corner of the bed, and then on the endpoint of the lower left corner to rotate the bed based on that side. Notice that now I can specify the new angle. I will click on the midpoint or the endpoint of the wall and notice that now the bed is aligned to this wall.